My name is Preksha Parek from Learner's Hub, Mumbai. This is my story called The Naira Escape in the Dark Cave. Let me tell you something about my story. This story is all about Naira and me as an explorer in the cave. We were misplaced in my foolishness. We escaped from this misty situation with great difficulty. It was as hot that you could fry an egg on the sidewalk. As Naira and I were paddling back from the mountains, an idea flashed into my mind. I conveyed, "Naira, why don't we solve a treasure mystery this vacations? They are such weary holidays. And I would be filled with gloominess if there would be no exciting and enthusiastic fun." Naira had the brainwave to explore the caves located in the jungle. I excitingly agreed. My face lit up with shine. We were ready to set off the next twilight. We viewed the silhouettes of the mountain pining for the purple skies with our torches. As we reached the massive cliff, there resided the suspicious caves. When we were positioned on the entry gate, an enormous cloud of bats flew over our heads, howling and shrieking. We were petrified. Still, we gathered up the courage to move ahead. It was a somber location with foul smell placed all over. Now, I could hear the nearby river raging like a bull. We had just reached midway when Naira said, "Let's return. I do not feel there is any conundrum hidden here." But I had a contrast reply. We had just embarked. We walked on and on. However, we did realize that we had entered the cavernous cave. Ultimately, in the pitch dark and eerie cave, we were lost. This was all because of my foolishness. Naira was weeping continuously and me busy in my whirl of stress. This endless hope lasted till my torch was burning. After my torch was blown out, our hopes were burnt as well. Could we find our way back? I wondered. It was a dark night. There seemed to be a chill in the air. I stood up from my place in horror. A drop of sweat covered my forehead, and my teeth chattered when I realized that an exit was not available. I could view a string of owls, led by their leader, flying proudly. Within a few minutes, I clapped my eyes on 8 tiny capering legs, known as black widows, creating silent, deafening noises. Now I was struck with terror and could feel my heartbeat reducing every second. The gigantic stones were as if they would create a landslide. My breath was heavy. At the crack of dawn, I found a piece of rope lying beside me. I mumbled to myself, "Why don't I tie this string to the rocks one after the other and pull them?" I attempted first. I received no result of this try. That is why I tried again, and this time Naira was a helping hand to me. On my last chance, a crack sounded in the stone and a ray of sun fell into my eyes. We created a gigantic hole and shuffled through it. Finally, we came out from this lengthened cave. I was determined, easygoing and firm, which helped us to exit the cave. This was the narrowest escape in my life. Thank you.